Welcome to the EPEVER tutorial series. In this video, we'll show you how to connect our MPPT controller to a lithium battery using the BMS-Link module and how to set it up so they can communicate smoothly. For this demonstration, we're using the Extra Series controller and an EPEVER lithium battery. Let's get started. Here's what you'll need: a controller, lithium battery, BMS-Link module, and RS-485 cables. Note, the BMS-Link and RS-485 cable are optional. Please prepare them in advance. First, connect the RS-485 communication cable labeled BAT to the battery. Next, connect the other end to the BMS-Link module. Then, connect the module to the controller. Once you've confirmed that the connections are correct, power on the system. Although everything is connected, but the device screen shows that communication has not started yet. So, we need to configure 5 key settings: enable COM port, primary mode, BMS protocol number, battery type, and battery capacity. Let's get started. Press PV plus and enter to browse PV parameters. Then long press the PV plus to enter the settings. Enable the COM port and switch the device to NN primary mode. NN primary mode is used for BMS communication, while secondary mode is used for RS-485 communication. If you're using PC software or the app to configure battery parameters, the controller must be in secondary mode. For direct battery communication, primary mode is required. Although the device is set to primary mode by default, we recommend double-checking the setting to ensure proper operation. Now, press PV plus, set the BMS communication protocol to the EPEVER standard protocol number, 34. Note, please adjust the protocol number based on the battery you are using. Now, let's configure the battery type and capacity. First, press BAT to view battery parameters. Then long press BAT to enter the settings. The default setting is sealed lead acid battery. Change it to a 4-string lithium iron phosphate battery. F04 means 4 strings of lithium iron phosphate batteries. Each battery cell delivers about 3.2 volts. 4 cells together give approximately 13.3 volts. Make sure your battery type and string number settings match your actual battery configuration. Then, update the battery capacity to the correct value for accurate performance. Restart the controller. Once powered on, the battery status bar will display the on icon indicating the controller is connected. Meanwhile, the BMS-Link module's indicator light will change from red to green and flash continuously, showing that the controller is connected to the battery and data is being transmitted. Now, the controller will monitor and protect your battery automatically, managing charging, discharging, and temperature safety. For long-term performance, we recommend checking your system regularly. Look out for dust, corrosion, and loose connections, and take corrective actions if necessary. If you have any questions, read the user manual for full instructions, or contact our support team anytime. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next EPEVER tutorial.